What's going on, people? Welcome to Raw Boxing TV. Let's go ahead and talk about this fight that has a potential fight of the year spot. We don't know yet. The year's not over. There might be fights that might take away that prize, but let's go ahead and start. The first thing I'm going to say is that I hope Pedro Angulo is doing okay. I hope that the orbital bone injury is not a career-ending injury like it was with Margarito. You know, it kind of bothers me to see things like this, especially when you know that a fighter has a family. You know, when you're a family man yourself, and that's his job. It's the only thing they do, the only thing they know how to do, actually, to provide for their family. And you just, the only thing you can do is hope that they can rebound from that injury. But let's go ahead, with that, I'm going to go ahead and start by saying that you guys that are fitting to criticize Lara are the same people that was criticizing Angulo on my prediction video. When I did my prediction videos, you guys were saying how much Lara was going to walk through Angulo because Angulo sucked, and I think it was MS505 that said, Angulo? Really? Walking the park for Lara. Just another nobody in his list. And remember when I said on my predictions, styles make fight. Don't think because a fighter is slow and he's facing a faster, slicker fighter, it's going to be a walk in the park. Because styles make fight. And I also would like to give a lot of credit to Virgil Hunter, because he took Angulo and took him to another level. I've never seen Angulo cut the ring as well as he did in this fight. Angulo was an expert, if I might say, at cutting the ring. No matter where Lara went, Angulo was there to welcome him. He was there. There's no arguing to that. I don't care how much you want to paint colors around it. The fact is, Angulo was an expert at cutting the ring in that fight. And Angulo took away Lara's power punches, other than the fact that, I like I said in my prediction, Angulo can take a punch. Yes, he went down as he lost by via knockout versus Kirkland, but Kirkland is another freaking mule that can kick, that he can hit like a mule kick. So how can you say that, you know, Angulo cannot take punches? Angulo can take any punch, except that night he fought a wrong fight versus Kirkland and paid the price. But Lara doesn't even have near as much power as James Kirkland. And besides that, it's a different fight style. Kirkland flat-footed, Lara moving, which when you move, it takes power away from your punches. But like I said, Angulo had a lot to do with that by grinding to the body. Yes, the majority of those body shots landed in the elbow, but still the impact is causing damage to the elbow, the arm. And that takes away your punch. That takes away your speed, your stamina. And Angulo did that very well tonight. And I also need to give Pedro Angulo credit, because he was smart enough to capitalize off of Erislandi Lara's mistakes. Why do I say that? Well, if we go back to the fight, the only two times that Angulo was able to get a knockdown was because he capitalized on Lara leaving his hands down. The first knockdown against the ropes, Lara goes to throw, I believe it was kind of like a jab slash hook with the right hand, following it up with an uppercut. But when he throws it, this is what he does. Or I believe his glove was around here. And as he does this, and his body's moving up, his chin is moving up, and you see that perfect left hand from Angulo just come and clip him and drop him. And that was the first time Lara had been down in his life as a boxer, including his amateur career. And Lara got up. Lara was winning that round till the knockdown. And Lara got up, and although he was hurt for the first few seconds, he was still staying in the pocket, moving around a little bit, and also counter-punching and also blocking the punches, and finished that round not in bad shape at all. He was coming back with punches of his own. So Angulo was able to capitalize on that mistake. Then, the second knockdown, what happened? As Lara goes to twist a punch, and this is, I don't know why he didn't understood or didn't do it in that fight, because this is something that's crucial when it comes to the Cuban way of fighting, is every time you throw a punch, that hand needs to come back. Every time you're gonna do a movement, anything, any movement, you should be protected at all time. Second knockdown, he capitalized off a second mistake Lara made, which is twist a punch with the chin in the air and his left hand and shoulder dropped. Lara goes to, and as he does this, goes down. Lara was pretty, I wouldn't say, oh my gosh, he's so hurt, but he was hurt. He took about 2 or 3 seconds sitting in the floor, got up, then went into defense mode, moved around a lot till he can recuperate himself a little bit, and then this was a minute and a half into the fight, I believe, and then went into his regular fighting mode, which is just counter-punching. And Angulo was able to capitalize. So at the end of the day, if you ask me, Angulo gains credit for this fight instead of losing credits for this fight, because he put up a good fight. A really good fight. I'm gonna give you my scorecards. I had it 96-92 with including the stoppage at the end. I gave the first three rounds to Lara, 10-9. The fourth round, 10-8 to Angulo. Then I had it from the fifth to the eighth for Lara at 10-9. Then I gave Angulo the 10-8 round. And then I gave Lara the 10-8 10th round, bringing it to 96-92. A lot of you might have it closer, but I understand a lot of you are focused on the hype. And you can't focus on the hype. All you gotta do is look at what's going on inside the ring. Don't look at just one fighter. Look at both fighters. Look at what both fighters are doing. The 1-2 was there for Lara all night long. Lara was the sharper puncher all night long. Lara was landing all night long with a simple 1-2, sometimes a lead 2 comeback with a 3 combination. So that's the reason I only gave Angulo the 2 knockdown rounds, because the other rounds, to me, although, listen, if you're in the ring or against another fighter and you're moving around and you're landing the cleaner shots, pow, and you're moving around, pow, and your opponent is coming at you, just putting pressure, cutting the ring on you, but not landing as clean, and you're just landing at will. Every time you shoot a 1-2, pum pum, it lands to the face. Would you rather me give the round to you or to your opponent? Please answer that in the comment section, and you can take that for what it's worth. I like the fact that Lara was knocked down, if you ask me, because he polished him as a professional fighter. It took him to that place, like I said, that he had never been before. He forced him to dig in survivor mode, and he forced him to better himself after making those mistakes. And sure, he did. He had comeback rounds in beautiful fashion. The controversial thing, was it a thumb? Was it a broken or orbital bone? We were just now looking at the fight. I think it was both. The jab that Lara threw, other than, like I said, the accumulations of 1-2 throughout the whole fight, the jab that Lara threw at first as Angulo moved down, they might have thumbed him. But since Angulo's defense was moving down and the jab came, as soon as that jab came, came that straight left hand and then another straight left hand to the same spot, and Angulo turned his back and that was it. And I believe that's when the broken orbital bone came. Now, what you might say, what stopped the fight? Was it the thumb in the eye or was it the broken orbital bone? I'm going to say it was the broken orbital bone. That's an intense pain. That's a very, very intense pain. It's never happened to me, but can you imagine having a bone broken around your eye? That's not a walk in the park. That's not an easy thing. So, was there a thumb? Sure. It wasn't intentional. Was there going to be a broken orbital bone? Yes, because the thumb came first, right? But really the jab didn't move Angulo's head. Angulo moved the head in the way that he was moving it to create defense from the attack. Lara just came back with another left hand like he's been landing all night long. Sometimes a blessing can be seen as a curse in the eyes of the beholder. Why do I say this? Because you guys might say Lara is exposed, or as I've been reading, Lara this, Lara that, you know, a bunch of nonsense like the usual YouTube haters. But it reminds me a lot of like Chavez Sr. versus Taylor, where Chavez was getting a rear end whoop the whole fight. And then bam! He won by knockout. Now, should we say Chavez sucks because of that and he got lucky on that night? No. The fight took place the way it did, and Chavez got that punch because he saw it and he took it, and the results were victory. Lara saw that punch, he took it, the results were history, victory, and Lara wasn't losing the fight at that point in time. You might say Lara looked bad and now he can lose versus Vanes, Trout, a bunch of names. But then again, it's the same thing you said when Rigondo got dropped twice versus American. Rigondo sucks. He got dropped twice by a nobody. And then he comes back and puts a zipper with stitches over your mouths. I hope this fight is a bait on a hook towards a bigger fight for Lara. I hope it works that way. I hope it does. Lara, champion of the world. Angulo, hope to see him back in the ring. Before I finish this video, I want to give credit to Angulo because he made a gutsy move. Did you read what was behind his trunks? It says immigration reform now. And I have to agree with him and say immigration reform now. It's time that this gets done and that we keep treating these people, whether they're Cubans or Mexicans or Salvadorians or whatever nation, it's stop that we keep treating them the way we do. Because this was a country formed and built by many nations. That's it for now. Subscribe.